support you. Every service, thank you. You have that say, amen?
Amen.
The Bible says, but ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. And ye shall be what?
Witnesses.
Unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth. Come on, read it with me. And there, verse 2, chapter 2, 3, and 4. And there appeared unto them cloven tongue like as a fire, and it set upon each of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak in tongues as the Spirit. I want you, before you take your seat, I want you to repeat after me. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
For refilling us.
For
refilling us.
Reviving us.
And setting our souls on fire.
And setting our souls on fire.
Come on, you may be seated.
Amen.
You know, when we come to church, we're not just coming because mama told us to come and daddy told us to come. Some of us have lost one parent or both, and still I heard Mama Kay talking about how her mother used to have her come to church. Amen. But in this dangerous day, in this terrorist time, we better be running to church. Because we never know where death is. We have no power. You know, the only thing we have power over is when we're here. But we don't know when we're going to leave. And so we need to understand that coming to church is a privilege. It's not a duty. It's a privilege. And the other night I talked about Lord reviving us. And I think we ought to understand that we need to get all that God has for us. We want all the refilling. How many folks have the Holy Ghost? How many folks have been filled with the Holy Ghost? And so when you have the Holy Ghost, you have power. Our souls are on fire. And then sometimes, I don't know about you, I like to come back to the altar and get a refill. You have been drinking coffee and you had it a little while and it gets a little lukewarm. And you want to top off. See, y'all ain't gotten hot and tired and sleepy, and we ain't even ate yet. But every now and then I want God to top me off. I want to get hot for the Lord. The Lord is calling for us to receive and to use the Holy Ghost. We have folks in the church in California that are holding positions and never been filled with the Holy Ghost. I want you to know, if you don't have the Holy Ghost, you're living beneath your privilege. Not always talked about on TV, you know, with Holy Spirit. There are all kinds of spirits, baby. I like to call it what it is, the Holy Ghost. The Lord is calling for the saints to be witnesses. Not only when we come to church, because you know you're here. The pastor take care of all that, but when we go out, I call it intelligent witnessing. Yeah. You don't knock folks over, you know, in the aisle while they're trying to shop. You got to know how to do it. And then we need to understand that we are living witnesses and living testaments. Our lives are on display at all times. So you shouldn't be coming to church looking and acting one way and leaving out, oh, let me talk to y'all for a moment. I understand that life has a way of beating us down sometimes. Sometimes life is hard. But when we have the Lord on our side, He takes us through the storms and the rain. We must stay prayed up.
All right.
Did y'all hear what I said? Not only when the praise team is up. Not only when the choir is up. And I think when the word of God comes alive, you ought to be just as excited to hear from the Lord. I know the praise team is very important. I certainly enjoyed this young man, full of energy. My God. Woo, I enjoyed you. But the praise team is not their job to get us jumping cartwheels. What they're doing is ushering in the Spirit of the Lord. But when all of us come in with our Holy Ghost power, you walk in here with your power, and I walk in here with my power. It ought to be a kinetic energy. And what I mean by kinetic energy, when you have kinetic energy, I have a little massager at my home. And sometimes I unplug the massager, but it still works. You know why? Because it's kinetic energy.